Hi, it's Trevor, and this is Discovering Gay History. Okay, today we are doing the grandfather of the gay rights movement, Frank Kameny. In 1953, in DC, there was a law passed that if you were gay, you could not be a civil servant, you could not work for the government. And in DC, that's like the main form of employment. So Frank was fired for being gay. He was an astronomer and teacher in DC, and he fought back. So what the DC police were instructed to do is they would dress in plain clothes, and then they would go out, they would like talk to people and go to like known gay places and try to get people to talk about their sex life. Once they got someone to start talking about their same-sex relationships, they would arrest them. What that ended up doing was putting you on a list, and that list was then given to the Civil Service Commission, and then you would shortly lose your job after that. So in Frank's past, he's from California. He was arrested in San Francisco because a plainclothes cop saw him get groped at a truck stop. So he was arrested and he was put on 3 years probation, and they said it was going to be expunged from his record. So 1958, his employers found out about that arrest, and two commission members called him. They said, "We have information that leads us to believe that you are a homosexual. Do you have any comment?" And he said, "What's the information?" They said, "We can't tell you." And he said, "Well, I can't respond. And in any case, I don't see how it's relevant to any rational concern or business of the government." But he was fired via a letter. They sent him a letter to his office saying that he had been fired. And he fought. He fought back. He exhausted all means of appeals. So he lost two appeals and was denied a petition to the Supreme Court, which he did the petition to the Supreme Court on his own, like by himself with no lawyer. And this was the first time that gay rights was taken to the Supreme Court. So it was a huge deal, even though it was denied. So what Frank was doing was like laying the groundwork for the gay rights movement to explode in just a few years. So after his Supreme Court petition was denied, he became a full-time activist. So in 1963, Frank drafted by himself a bill to overturn the sodomy laws in DC, and that bill did not go into effect until 1993. So in 1962, he worked with Barbara Giddings, who is a Quain, and we'll get to in another video, to remove from the APA homosexuality from the mental disorders. So 1973, it was removed as a mental disorder. And in 2009, Frank received an apology letter saying, "We're sorry that we fired you for being gay." And he said that he accepted the apology. He had heart disease and died in 2011 on Coming Out Day at the age of 86. During World Pride, his name, along with 49 other people, was added to the National LGBTQ Wall of Honor. That man did a lot of stuff in his life, but that is Frank Kameny. All right, we'll see you tomorrow.